You mentioned you being from a border state. Mm-hmm. Arizona.
Arizona, yeah.
Jeff Flake.
I know.
How do you feel? Talk to us about Jeff. Why is Jeff Flake quitting the Senate? He's so good.
He's intensely unpopular with Republicans. Wow. And I should say my father is intensely unpopular with Republicans. I think Jeff Flake is the least popular and my father's the third least popular because I think we are the party of Trump right now. And if you go against him, especially as vocally and intensely as Jeff Flake has, there are ramifications for the base, especially in Arizona. Go ahead.
Do you think that he should primary Donald Trump? Should Jeff Flake primary Donald Trump and get this conversation going at a national level?
I think it's a nice pipe dream in this room. I don't know how it works in Iowa and New Hampshire. I don't know if there's, as much as I want to believe that there's this room for more independent, more moderate Republicans, I just don't know if Trumpism is leaving anytime soon, and it's more than likely he will run for president again. And I would like to see it just from a debate standpoint, but I don't think there's any chance of him winning.
But I mean, you're a McCain. I mean, don't you think this on principle they should do it? You sound almost like kind of resigned a little bit about the party.
Because I know what the party is. I'm not,
you
know, it's Trumpism right now. Have no doubt about it. Trumpism has really taken over, and it's been a difficult thing for me to come to terms with.
So then do you see why sometimes people do throw this lump category against all the Republicans? Well, you're all this negative thing if the political force of Trumpism has so much momentum.
I do understand it, but I also think there's nuance in it because a lot of people voted for President Trump because they were so disillusioned mm-hmm. with Hillary Clinton or because they were more worried about their economy than the job, and they have let a lot go.
I got another question for you. Mm-hmm. One of the things your dad got criticized for was picking Sarah Palin.
And I totally forgot about that.
Yeah. But maybe he was ahead of his time. In some ways, isn't this the party, not really just of Donald Trump, but isn't this really the party of Sarah Palin? And if she had, she were to run now, someone like that run now, how well do you think a Sarah Palin would do in the modern Republican Party?
I still think President Trump is lightning in a bottle. I don't think he's going to be emulated very easily. And the billionaires who are Mark Cuban and such who are talking about running for president, I don't think it's as easy. I think it's a very specific man in a very specific moment. I think the question of Sarah Palin, because I've heard it argued to me before that she was sort of like the first opening of the populist movement within the Republican Party, I'm mixed on it because part of me thinks, yes, that could be true. The other part of me thinks that it was just the wave where the party was going. I don't know. I just wish there was more room in the Republican Party for different, perspectives and different leaders. But I've thought that since 2009. Mm-hmm. So this isn't something new. It just seems to be particularly insular right now.
Tell me about your relationship with Joe Biden.
Oh, my gosh. If he runs for president, I'm screwed in every way.
Why do you love Joe Biden?
Well, he's been friends with my father for like 30-something years, and his son has had glioblastoma multiforme like my father has. And there's something about him that I think he's experienced so much pain and trauma in his life that he just understands pain and trauma in a way that I don't think most people do. And he has become, I was always friendly with him in the sense that you're friendly when you see someone socially who's friends with your parents. But in the past 6 months, he's really become someone I have turn to when I feel like the world is falling in. And he is the former Vice President of the United States of America, and the fact that he makes time for that and cares and says the kind of wonderful things that he said on The View, which I didn't expect to cry and I ended up doing. He's a very special man. I disagree with him 75% politically, but he's such a, there's a level of decency and character that reminds me of my dad. And I don't know. If he runs for president, I don't know what I want to do. I might have to get out of business because I don't think I could bring myself to say anything negative about him. No. I mean it. Yeah. It'd be too hard.